40 minutes past the hour on this Saturday morning. Thank you for being with us. His 7 Tour de France titles are gone. Cycling's governing body says records are going to show that no one won those races. And Lance Armstrong's real battles may be just beginning. Of course, this is all because of a doping scandal that has been called epic. CNN's Quentin McDermott has this report for us. Well, CNN newsroom starts. I know, isn't that something? Yeah. At the top of the hour? Fred is with us, of course.
Good to see you.
You too.
You've had a great morning.
Yes.
I know, rocking and rolling. So much going on. We've got a full day as well. We're going to begin, of course, taking. So this Sandy is really potentially really kind of interrupting a lot of the early voting that we've been seeing. It's certain states along the Atlantic coast.
And if those people who wanted to go early vote, if they will go vote on the actual day if they can't get out early. So it'll be interesting.
Hey,
so good to see you,
good
Fred.
To see
Thank
you, Christy.
You'll see her in just a bit.
Okay.
I know you've heard about this one. A little girl's dead. Her parents are suing, and the target of their law. No, but we just keep looking at it, thinking maybe it'll rub off, right?
Somewhere. Hey, so what's for breakfast this morning? Well, one company is hoping that you'll gravitate toward their new skinny bagels.
Does that sound appetizing?
Hmm.
They're actually...
19 minutes till the top of the hour. Good to be with you this morning. We're in the E block.
Entertainment.
Yeah, it's the entertainment. Oh, and she sings, too. All right, thank you, Christy. Oscar nominations are out. Everyone seems to be talking about who did not make the Oscar A-list instead of who did.
Yeah, I mean, so let's talk about all of it with Kim Serafin. She's the senior. Welcome back. 23 minutes past the hour right now. And a man who paid $350,000 for a chance to hunt and kill a black rhino is now being hunted. His name's Corey Knowlton. And he says he and his entire family have gotten death threats.
And now we have word of more of his stories. He and Ed Lavandera has the story. Good morning, Ed. Reception be like. Joining us to discuss, Fred Malik. He's a former campaign manager and founder of Thayer Capital Partners. Sir, good to have you. You know, where I want to start is with the question, is Chris Christie, for the purposes of raising money for himself or others, damaged goods?
Oh, Victor, not at all.
Campaign manager, let's just to hypothetically say, if you were Christie's campaign manager, how would you proceed at this point? What do you think is most important?
Well, I think the most important thing for him is to continue to stay on his job.
Committee in the New Jersey Assembly, they've got, from what I understand, 2 years of subpoena power in this. That takes us right up to 2016. And if he decides to get into the race, then you've got people testifying, at least in this one investigation, there are others. The question is, why would the big money folks get behind Chris Christie knowing that that could go on until 2016 right now?
Well, first of all...
So, Fred, the Miami Herald reported that a top Republican lobbyist called Christie, quote, horrific as a person. And apparently it didn't have anything to do with the scandal, the Bridgegate scandal necessarily, but it had something to do with that hug between Christie and Obama during Superstorm Sandy. Does Christie have bigger problems here?
I don't believe he does. Look, he's the governor of the state of New
Plus already. Is Governor Rick Scott going to be with him at these fundraisers? And is there any press available? From what I understand, correct me if I'm wrong, Governor Rick Scott's not going to appear with him. And if they were to appear together, these are closed-door fundraisers anyway.
Well, I think he is appearing, but I can't answer. You know what? It'd be kind of like leaving Tom Brady off the plane going to Denver. That's a non-starter. It's not going to happen.
Of the Republican Governors Association. Fred Malik, good to talk to you.
Thank you for
Great
being here.
Great to talk to you. Thanks for having me.
Sure.
Sure. And still to come on New Day, those iconic horse-drawn carriage rides around...
In more than 6 years, a black female cast member joined Saturday Night Live, and it happens tonight.
Yep, all eyes are going to be on SNL and...
Welcome back into the CNN newsroom. We're having a conversation now about black women and entertainment, and we have comedians Deborah Wilson and Lonnie Love with us. The Academy Award nominations came out this week, and Lupita Nyong'o was nominated for her role as a slave in 12 Years a Slave. And I want to talk about the nominations for